And would you please welcome on stage from the Netherlands into the last 16 on his European Tour debut, Martijn Kleermaker. And his opponent from England, a former World Championship and World Match Play semi-finalist, and the 2004 World Masters Champion, it's the King, Mervyn King!
Darts Championship we have had today. Michael van Gerwen, the world number one, beaten 6-5 by Michael Smith, the bully boy. What a week it's been for him after his 9 dart exploits in Dublin in the Premier League on Thursday. But MVG, the first wait, or the wait for a first title in 2020, goes on. And this drought almost now, I think we can call it, Paul. Can you just say hello momentarily?
Hello.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, good afternoon. Yeah, this drought, if you can call it that, of European Tour titles goes on. MVG falling at the first hurdle today. No way past Michael Smith, despite a late rally in an eventual 6-5 defeat. So Smith safely through. And we also know that joining Smith in the quarterfinals this evening will be an unseeded player, because he will face one of these two. Mervyn King, a former European Tour champion, against the debutant Martijn Kleermaker, and Kleermaker having a European Tour debut to remember, beating Stephen Bunting 6-4 in his first round match on Friday, and then yesterday, even more impressive you could say, in accounting for Joe Cullen, the number 9 seed. Is this a step too far, or can the dream stay alive for the Dutchman?
First leg, Mervyn to throw first. Game on.
As the puppy gets us underway, I don't think there's any real fear for Martijn Kleermaker at this point. I think he's settled into PDC life very well indeed. But just get the feeling that this time of year and the position that Mervyn is in with the one-year rolling rankings, to keep himself in with a shout of Grand Prix and match players and things like that, I think he sees this as a huge opportunity to bolster his ranking money. Martijn, of course, will not be defending 99. Any of that all year, very good.
That's a great position to be in. Everything is a free hit. You are effectively playing 94. With the house money for 12 months, aren't you, when you are in your debut campaign on the Pro Tour circuit. The average really dragged up yesterday by Kleermaker as well. 91.8 against Joe, as opposed to the 83 or so he had against Bunting, although he did miss a whole host of match darts. 7 match darts alone in one leg in that win against Bunting, who did trail 5-1 in that 100. One before clawing his way back. 6-4 in the end.
Record 41.
And King looking at 1-4-1 for an early hold of throw.
Yeah, tidy start from Merv.
Treble 19. Would have left double 12.
109.
And Kleermaker can step in and eye up this 170. This would be some way to start things off. And he's got a chance.
That would have been eye-catching.
Mervyn, you require 32.
Mervyn breathes again in somewhat familiar territory, or not so much these days. Doesn't leave 32 as much as he used to, but fours need to go. Oh, lovely anchor dart from Merv. Take that one-leg advantage. But yesterday, Merv was imperious against someone who is
59.
A heavyweight in modern-day darts in Dozer. But Mervyn likes to play against the new crop. likes to say that he's still here to compete. Yesterday was proof of that.
95.
It's the best thing about this game, Rob, it's the different characters, but it's the age differences as well you get with certain matches. There's Team Claremaker there. Merv tends to travel on his own 95% of the time. This time he's driven to Hasselt. Especially in this part of Europe, he likes to drive, or maybe there's the option of getting the motorbike out.
Easy ride. I've got visions of like Dennis Hopper. Mervyn King doing his easy rider across the Autostrada and the Autobahns of Western Europe.
I saw the Goldwing he had a few seasons ago. That was a speedy little number.
89.
Can't quite envisage him on a Kawasaki Ninja, though.
Kawasaki, another 60. Word that sounds better if you say it with a Geordie accent. There's a few of those.
You have to get Chris Dolby to say it in Sindelfingen.
Claremaker might be another one as well.
Claremaker.
100.
Yeah, Claremaker actually means tailor.
Yeah, it's the second coming, isn't it, this weekend? Walking in a Claremaker wonderland.
Well, that'll catch on.
25. Moving, you require 96.
I actually really like Martijn's game. I think he's got a lot to offer. But Merv is being very consistent in the early parts of this match. That's perfect to sneak it underneath.
On the second leg, Merv.
He looks ready to put in a real shift today, does Merv. He was here early as usual. And
game on.
Claremaker has got issues here.
Yeah, I think King is perhaps grateful that he was given, or the way things panned out, he was on second today rather than hanging around until the last match of the afternoon session, because he does like to get to the venue early, settle himself in, put in at least a couple of hours more practice on the boards outside, and
easy one.
This will just aid his cause. Claremaker, though, I've got to say, I've been very impressed. He's obviously played with a very fearless manner. He hasn't looked overawed by the occasion. This is his European Tour debut. A Tour Card winner at European Q School last month, or in January 2020. Happy 1st of March. Happy St. David's Day, by the way. Gerwyn Price flying the flag for Wales later on. No Johnny Clayton, though. He was beaten last night. As Claremaker rattles in a 180 that rather caught his family off guard.
Seeing as it is St. David's Day, I think everybody at the PDC would like to send their condolences to the family and friends of Kerry Morgan, who passed away yesterday.
139.
One of the real characters and
of Welsh darts, yeah.
You know, what a great player in the 80s boom period of darts, and his unusual action will live in people's memories and his darts for many, many years. It's really sad to see him go.
Nice touch, Paul. Claremaker, 101. Tops.
81.
Just pulled that down, didn't he? And okay, he will get another opportunity. And it is for a break of throw as well. So Claremaker has the chance to get back on track here.
On the subject of Wales, last year, Martijn Claremaker won the Welsh Open, which is a very hard open to win in Prestatyn. Tens. Turn it to fives. Don't leave Merv on 100. Because if he gets the single 20 here, you know he's going 5-16s.
Yeah, the Welsh Open, those nights in Prestatyn, never reaching the end.
Doesn't get to the 32 shot.
45.
Claremaker breathes again. Good guide.
Excellent guide. And well used as well. And Claremaker back in the hunt here, having found the break back, and on we go. Mervyn King just with something to think about here. King won't be rattled by that. Great performance by Mervyn King yesterday, I've got to say, as well, against Glenn Durrant. You touched upon it earlier. An average of 105.98. It was just that one leg of more than 15 darts, but elsewhere it made very, very good reading for Mervyn King and the Merverts out there. 14 darts, 11 darts, 12 darts, and 13 darts to round things off. Very strong against one of the informed players right now, you've got to say.
I think when he initially heard Dan call his fans the Merverts, I'm not sure he was keen on it, but I think he's embraced it a little bit now.
Well, he's got no choice, really.
He doesn't,
to be honest.
Merv has got a lot of fans out there. And I think we touch a lot on his early entry into the venue, and sometimes he's taken it to the maximum. I remember the Newcastle Premier League once, he was there 8 hours beforehand, which I think was a little bit much. But because he travels on his own most of the time, he said to me once that he'd much rather be in the venue, surrounded by people he likes, and in a professional environment where he can prepare in his own pace, rather than sitting in the hotel room twiddling his thumbs. And when you put it like that, it makes a lot of sense.
Great 180 to get in position this time. It's on the clear Mac throw. 105 for Mervyn King for an instant break back.
19's first. Now the 54.
Would have left the double 16, but it's not to be. Clearmaker gets a chance here to level things up, looking at 82.
One shot at tops.
42.
Just a little bit too tall, a bit like Martin. Kenny, clean up double 16 this time. Should be able to with that one.
16.
Oh, and it was in the way, through the exact same dart as dart two, and it just collided with it.
Yeah, he wasn't too convincing on his doubles yesterday, Clearmaker, but he got away with it against Jokerlund, but I don't think he'll get away with it today against Mervyn King, and that was a long way inside. Double 10 to salvage this one, and again, he's come inside by some distance as well, and that just underlines the point. Mervyn King, strong favourite now for an instant break back. It would be a third break of the match. Well, another one of those, Merv.
24.
And it's not to be. A little bit careless with that first dart, wasn't he?
I think he was quite flummoxed that he couldn't sneak one under the first dart. You can see the bright side of it now.
Well, you don't often see Merv with a wry smile like that after a moment of misfortune.
He's playing Mervyn to throw first.
But the big Dutchman, Martin Clearmaker.
Game on.
Levels things up at two apiece.
I think Martin just trying to G the crowd up there a little bit. I'm not sure that Merv liked that. But an interesting best of seven leg match 16. Now, seeing as we're 2-2. But you're absolutely right when it comes to Martin's doubles. Yesterday and the day before, 100. There were a lot of misses. So if he can polish that up, he's going to get a lot more wins. I feel that that may be, because of his pace, something that just needs a little bit more measuring.
I think the other thing you can say, I mean, win or lose this match 100. For Clearmaker, what it will do, it will really, or this weekend, what he's achieved this weekend, will really stand him in good stead moving forward. And when he turns up at Pro Tour events in the future, I think maybe in the first six Pro Tour events he might have been a little bit overawed, you know, the new kid on the block, you know, starting your first day at the new school, and it might just been a bit too much for him. I think this will really settle him down, and I think moving forward he won't feel so overawed when he's rubbing shoulders with the game's greatest.
Yeah, the first thing you got to do when you walk in the room is feel comfortable. I remember my first PDC event, I didn't feel comfortable at all in Las Vegas. Walking in, I only knew about two or three people. But once you know a few people and you know where things are, know how the draws come out, what time, it's a great structure, the PDC. That's what the BDO guys coming through to the PDC tell me more than anything else. Everything is so pinpoint time-wise.
Yeah. And I suppose when you are a first-time winner of a tour card, there's a lot to take on board about procedures, about registration and what have you. Mervyn King is, of course, a stalwart of the game. No such concerns for him, and no such concerns either with double 16 for a 3-2 lead.
100.
Another thing the BDO guys used to say when they switched codes was, oh, it's really nice to start a tournament at 12 o'clock instead of 9:30 in the morning. Means I could have an extra hour in bed or two.
59.
Well, that was a 14 darter for Mervyn King. Started off with a 15 darter.
60.
Merv's done well there. He was under pressure with Martin on 50. So to take that 62 out on a double, which he's missed a bit in this match already, just goes to show what kind of focus he's showing.
140.
If Merv gets to big events like the match play and the Grand Prix, we know what he can do, because last year he was showing it
100
at the tender age of what he is right now, which is over 50.
Well, Clearmaker's still in this, obviously, at 3-2, but the concern is 100. That the two legs he's won, he's done it in 36 darts, so he's had to rely on King errors to get the job done, if you like, and 58. I don't think he can get away with that for too much longer.
Not at all. If Mervyn senses weakness, he's going to step on your throat.
Winner of this to face Michael Smith, just to remind you once again, the draw bracket follows the order of play this afternoon, so we've got Peter Wright and Danny Noppert coming up. That's a lovely
171.
Love that setup. Fantastic darts, but Mervyn's got 62 again. This time he only gets one dart out of double, and this time he chooses tops. Oh, wonderful. 62 on the double. Gets him a break of throw. And he shuts out Clear Macker again.
Well, he's finishing over the last two legs has been exactly what he needed. And Clear Macker in the relatively unfamiliar position of having to come from behind. Yeah, Peter Wright, the world champion, against Danny Noppert on the way next. The winner of that to face Christoph Rutajski and Rob Cross, who meet in our fourth match of the afternoon. And on we go. We've also got Gerwyn Price, the number three seed, in action later against Jamie Hughes, Mensur Suljovic and James Wade. Two more former European Tour champions with us later on. Also, we've got the all-Dutch clash between Van Dijvenbode and De Zwaan. Loads to get our teeth into as the afternoon moves on. And then tonight, the quarters, the semis and the final itself from 7 o'clock local time. Kleermaker just chasing this leg now as well on the king throat.
140.
Well, Mervyn's looking to do something quite similar to what he did 21 years ago.
So we're looking at 1999.
Correct. He won the Antwerp Open that year.
Right.
So he's looking to get another Belgian title. It'll be some achievement.
100.
Antwerp Open for quite a while was a PDC event. No longer, of course, but always well represented that tournament. There have been some great players who have won that one.
82.
Kleermaker from this position is looking for the 138. Only gets one treble, but that may be good enough. The finishing, like you said, Rob, it's been brilliant. The last couple of legs, if he gets a shot at a double, he's going to scare it.
Yeah, one treble will leave an opportunity, two opportunities for a double, but he may not get the chance. Single 14 for tops for Mervyn King for a 1-1-4.
74. Montaigne requires 78.
And that's very much out of keeping with what Mervyn King has produced so far today. Slip up there, leaves 75. Just has to recalibrate here, and he's missed the 25 as well. And
57.
That was a bit of a letdown for Kleermaker, because from 78 you'd expect him to get at least 40. One dart for the double.
Yeah, not to get a shot for the leg is criminal, really. Especially when he's had a fortunate go into the treble one instead of the single, which gives him the 25 in bullshot, but he doesn't even get the 25, which seals his fate, really.
Yeah, 16 darts for Mervyn King. That was the worst leg of the match for Mervyn King. Everything else has been 15 darts or fewer. Pretty much in keeping with what he was doing yesterday. Not as emphatic, the scoring, but it's good, consistent stuff in the main from Mervyn King. There we see that. Had that one 16 dart leg yesterday, likewise today, and it's more than enough so far.
97.
That's very Merv, isn't it?
It is.
Winning legs.
It is.
Certain averages look around about right, and I think Kleermaker's, the way he's performed 60. So far, it's the tiniest bit flattering. Whereas Merv's, if I wasn't looking at stats and just watching the match, I would have thought around about the 60. 95 mark.
Yeah, ultimately, though, you can look at that all day long, but I think the 10 darts that he's missed at a double will effectively be what he reflects on when he comes to chew over this game later on.
43.
Not over yet, of course. People have one from 5-2 down. Mervyn won't sleep very well if that happens.
100.
He wants to play against Michael Smith tonight at 7 o'clock.
Yeah, well, there's a chance here for Kleermaker to get at least another leg on the board anyway. And as you say, I'm not writing him off just yet, but you'd have to say King is an overwhelming favourite from here. 44 away, tops he wants then. And this time the finishing is true. That's more like it from Kleermaker. That's exactly what he needs to do. It's just not been there in the main so far today. And maybe because the pressure was off a little bit, maybe he just loosened up and just started to breathe a bit more easier.
Yeah, Merv got a treble five there, which left 163, and that was why he had that wry smile. But the one thing about Martijn there, when he gets the timing perfect,
60,
he makes things like that 104 look so simple. And that, for me, is very encouraging for his future. I think he's going to cause a lot of great players a lot of problems. He could turn into one of those streaky players where he has a hot 2 or 3 weeks and put in some monstrous stats.
99.
Yeah, I'll be interested to see how he fares in his forthcoming Pro Tour events.
There's qualifiers coming up as well for Leverkusen and Munich. ET's 3 and 4, European Tours 3 and 4. There again, he makes it look great. He can't even finish from 3-4-2.
Well, it gets the crowd going, certainly, but he is on a bogey number. Mervyn King, I don't think we'll be panicking just yet, because he can make 100. A big impression here. And I think this is still very much Mervyn King's leg to lose and match to lose as well.
65.
Good switch. Excellent switch. Gets into the two darter. That's really good counting.
However, Mervyn King, irrespective of that 97, just taking a moment now.
He was going to go 20s, but now he's gone 16s.
Yeah, he did it twice yesterday, and as sure as night follows day, surely he's going to find this double eights. And he King does, and shot. Mervyn King stays true to his principles on treble 16, double 16, although it was the double eight that rescued him in the end. And that was a very Mervyn King performance, wasn't it? All the way through his first four legs that he won, 15 darts, 15 darts, 14 darts, 15 darts. Very consistent stuff from the Nervurts, or for the Nervurts, I should say. And Martijn Kleermaker, it's the end of the road for the Dutchman making his debut on the European Tour, but I think he can reflect on a job well done here, because Kleermaker has certainly caught the eye this weekend. Certainly one to watch out for the rest of 2020, both on the Euro Tour and on the Pro Tour as well. But it's Mervyn King who goes through to face the bully boy Michael Smith in the quarterfinals later tonight. Up on stage next, we've got the world champ Peter Wright against Danny Noppert.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a great European Tour debut for Martijn Kleermaker. And into the quarterfinals, it's the King, Mervyn King. Mervyn, congratulations. Great win for you. I mean, his European Tour debut, what a debut he's had. I mean, he beat Stephen Bunting, he beat Joe Cullen. Did you take notice of that before the game?
Who were they? I'm joking. Yeah, of course. I mean, he shoe his form in the world, so I knew what I was up against. Great player. Nice guy. Great player. He didn't show his true form tonight, but neither did I. So I looked at the game and I let a few early ones go, and I thought that was a fair result. The way we both played, we can both play better, but that is what it is.
Next round, Michael Smith for you. I mean, we know the almost famous saying by now, if Mervyn King turns up, Mervyn King wins.
You know it.
Ladies and gentlemen, into the quarterfinals, the one and only, the King, Mervyn King. And we're going to be back with the third match of this afternoon. It's going to be Danny Noppert against the reigning world champion, Snakebite, Peter Wright. The most dramatic.